Hello dear students, welcome to this English class. Students, as you are aware, we have started with the revision for semester 1 exam. I have already conducted revision part 1 and part 2, wherein I have covered the revisions of 2 poems and 2 chapters. Today I shall conduct the revision of the remaining portion. So please be attentive. Let's get started. Semester 1, revision part 3. Prose section, chapter number 6, Brown Wolf. Brown Wolf, written by Jack London. Remember, the writer of this particular story is Jack London. So this story revolves around a dog who has lost his way home and is wandering around in search of his master's house. And he then arrives at the cottage of, do you remember? At the cottage of Walt and Madge. Walt and Madge are very kind and helpful. They allow him to stay at the cottage and they take good care of him. They feed him. They take good care and they love him a lot. But the dog seems to feel homesick. He is missing his master and therefore he does not respond to the love that Walt and Madge shower on him. He does not respond at all. Then finally he makes many attempts to escape. He goes in search of his master's house. But each time he goes, he is lost and then Walt gets him back. And when many times this occurs, Walt finally puts a metal badge around his neck that has the metal plate has his name and cottage address. So if the people find him, they can always bring him to his cottage. They call the dog as Wolf because his features resembles a wolf. The dog then tries many times to go towards his master's home. Each time he goes towards the north. So Walt understands that his house is somewhere towards the north. After many such futile attempts, futile means useless attempts, finally the dog decides to stay at the cottage, and slowly and steadily he then starts responding to Walt and Madge and he allows them to touch him. This is a great victory for Walt and Madge because he does not allow anyone else to touch, only Walt and Madge. So they are very happy. Then one fine day, as they are going for a walk, they come across a stranger who has come there in search of his sister. When the dog hears that stranger's voice, he suddenly shows that he is very happy and he responds to that stranger and he shows that he knows that he is very happy that the stranger is there, that he has recognized his voice. And Walt and Madge are very surprised because he has never allowed any stranger to touch him. So here he is responding very well to the stranger. During the course of their interaction, the stranger then says that the dog actually belongs to him. When Madge expresses a surprise that the dog has never been so responsive to any stranger, so then the stranger says that that's because the dog actually belongs to him. Now Walter and Madge are very nervous because they don't want to lose the dog. They like him a lot, and therefore they ask the stranger how he can prove that the dog belongs to him. Then the stranger gives some commands and the dog responds to every command that he shoots out. So that proves that he actually belongs to that stranger. Now the name of the stranger is Skip Miller. So now Walt asks the stranger if he would like to sell. If he would like to sell, then Walt would be willing to buy him. But the stranger refuses. He says no way he's going to sell him because the dog actually belongs to him alone and he is the rightful owner. So then Madge asks that we need to take the dog's opinion. We need to consider him as to whom he would like to stay. So then afterwards they decide mutually that they would consider the dog's decision, and the stranger, that is Skip Miller, also agrees because he knows that surely the dog will choose him, whereas Walt and Madge are sure that the dog would like to stay at the cottage itself with them. So now the agreement is that, as suggested by Skip Miller, that Skip Miller will try to go away from them, and then he say then they would see whether the dog would follow him. If he would follow him, Walt and Madge will not call him back. And if he does not follow Skip Miller but prefers to stay at the cottage, then Skip Miller will not call him. That was the agreement, and that is what they do. So Skip Miller moves away from that place, and he gives Madge a handshake, and that time the dog licks the stranger's hands, and he also places his forelegs on Madge's hips. So this is a way wherein he expresses his feelings that he wants them all to stay together, and he would like to stay with all of them. Then later on, when Skip Miller shakes hand, gives Walt a handshake, the dog does a similar thing with Walt and Skip Miller. That means he wants all of them to stay together. Then as Skip Miller says goodbye and he moves away, the dog is very, very shocked. And then he goes walking behind Skip Miller, and he holds his hand as though requesting him, pleading him to stop and stay. But Skip Miller does not stop. So when he does not listen, the dog again goes back to Walt and Madge, and he tries to nudge them. That means he tries to push them, asking them to tell Skip Miller to stay. Now Walt and Madge do not move, they do not budge, they do not move at all as per the agreement. So then the dog feels helpless, and he just doesn't know what to do. But now he has to take a decision. He has to choose between the two of them. So then when he sees Skip Miller going, it is very difficult for him to take a decision because he loves his master Skip Miller, but at the same time he also has started loving Walt and Madge because they have been so caring. And you know, dogs are so faithful, especially to the people who share their love on them. So now he finds it very difficult to take a decision, but he has to take a decision, and that also he has to take a prompt decision. So then when he sees Skip Miller going and not turning back or not stopping, finally he takes a decision, and that is he goes running towards Skip Miller and does not turn back. Now he does not turn back. There are two meanings. It means that he has taken a firm decision that he will follow, he will stay with Skip Miller, who has been his owner. Okay? But at the same time, he also does not turn back to Walter and Madge, because he knows that they would be feeling sorry, and he doesn't want to see that sad face. Okay, he doesn't have the courage to see them feeling sad. So this is it, that the dog finally decides to go with Skip Miller, that is his owner. So this is the story. I will quickly do the revision of the summary points and the meanings. See, here you can see the dog interacting with the stranger Skip Miller, how he's responding. And here you can see how he is going behind Skip Miller. He has taken the final decision while Walt and Madge just look at him very sadly. Okay, let's take the meaning. Tremulously means with a shaky voice. I reckon is I think. Puzzled is confused. Some summary point. The dog had arrived from nowhere at the cottage of Walt Irwin and Madge. The dog proved to be unsociable, as it did not respond to their friendly gestures and did not allow them to touch him. It was a great victory for the young couple because they alone were allowed to touch the dog. Walt and Madge and Skip Miller decided to let the dog make the choice. The dog wanted them all to stay together. The dog finally made up his mind to stay with Skip Miller. The dog rested his weight on Walt and licked both men's hands. It implied that he wanted to stay with all of them together. So students, we have completed the revision of this particular chapter. I request you to go through all the videos of this chapter, the videos wherein I have given the complete explanation. So there are three videos, Brown Wolf, part A, B and C. Also go through all the meanings and the notes. Today I have taken this revision of certain points. Go through the videos, go through all the notes that are there in part A, B and C, all the meanings, and also through the notes that are given. I hope you are preparing well for your exam. Also, please read the lesson very well. Thank you, and God bless you. All the best for your exams.